this is Heather Hoffman, and today I'm playing with the brand new December 2019 card kit of the month and putting together this fun gnome card. I just kind of started off with all the supplies in front of me, and you'll kind of see how I was inspired as I went along. It's pretty rare that I do a video and I really have no idea what I'm doing when I start, but I kind of just went with it on this one. And I really wanted to use the adorable little gnome wafer thin dies. And as I was flipping through the Photoplay Kringle & Company 6x6 pattern paper in the kit, I saw that one sheet that had all of just the little gnome faces on it, and that kind of inspired me. So I started matching up some different pattern paper to kind of coordinate things together. I trimmed off a little strip there off of one piece of the pattern paper, and you might notice that I trimmed the width of it. I trimmed the other panel to the size of an A2 card front, so I can still use that later for that. And then I used the scraps just to only cut the hat out. I didn't worry about the whole design. And then I used some scraps of white cardstock to cut out the nose and the beard, and also to cut out the outline, but I didn't worry about the bottom of it. And I'll show you why, because in a little bit I'm going to actually trim that off so that I'm making a gnome without a whole body with just the head. So kind of a fun twist and a way to use this die a little bit differently. So I'm starting off with those pieces I've die cut from white, and I'm coloring them with Copic markers. I'm using two shades there. I'll list them on the screen so you know what colors they are. So I did all the noses and I added some shading just with those two colors, super quick and simple. Then I used some warm gray markers, also Copics, to color the beard a little and add some texture. And I kept it just really quick and simple. I basically kind of flicked across the whole thing with the lightest color. And then I did the same thing building each color, and that's kind of going to give a little bit the effect of hair. You notice I'm not hitting the whole thing, I'm just kind of swiping across it, holding it in place with my finger. I'm using a just kind of a clear mat there to keep my ink from getting on my work surface. This is a sheet protector that I've just slipped a piece of white printer paper into, and I like to use that to protect my work surface. It's really inexpensive, small and portable, and super simple to clean as well. All right, and then the final little touch here of the Copic coloring. I was about to assemble them, and I thought it'd be fun to use a similar shaded Copic marker to that red and just kind of add some little slouchy marks. It gives a little bit more of a 3D effect to those hats, which I thought was kind of fun. I've been looking at gnome decorations everywhere, and a lot of them have that slouchy effect, so I thought that would be kind of fun. Now I'm using some Gina K Connect liquid glue just to quickly assemble these. I started by putting the hat on, then the nose, and then the beard. And then I'm going to skip ahead a little as I finish the last one. I did the same thing on all of them, so I figured you didn't have to watch all three. And now that I have them assembled, I'm going to use my scissors to fussy cut that extra off the bottom. So now you can kind of see why I wasn't worried about cutting the bottom of the die. I wanted to make sure it went down far enough to go around the beard. And then I've skipped ahead a little to finish cutting those out, because I did the same thing and you don't have to watch it three times. All right, now I grabbed that other pattern paper I had, and I wasn't quite sure at this point what I was going to do with it, but I decided to die cut it into circles. So I pulled out my Simon Says Basic Circles wafer dies. It's a nesting set, and I picked a size that was about right, and then I die cut one size larger out of white cardstock just to kind of add another layer behind, and it helps that black plaid paper pop out just a little bit more. So I layered those on and kind of planned my placement, and I realized a little type A there, I had to make sure my plaid went straight up and down. Next, I'm going to pull out the fun Gnome for the Holiday stamp set that's included in the kit. And I picked, I kind of played around with a couple different ways to decide which sentiment I liked, and I ended up settling on that I love you gnome matter what. I love all the fun little punny sentiments in this set too, it's super fun. So I grabbed that sentiment off of the stamp, and I'm going to heat emboss it in white on black cardstock. I used my Embossing Buddy powder tool to kind of run over it to keep any of the embossing powder from sticking except where I've stamped my image. I used Simon Says stamp embossing ink to stamp it, and then sprinkled on, of course, Simon Says white embossing powder. And I'm going to quickly heat set that, and then usually when I do this, I either die cut it after I heat emboss it, or sometimes like this, I just trim it down with my paper trimmer. I like to do it on a larger piece of cardstock because it's a little easier to hold on to and add the heat embossing. And then I can just trim it down to size with my paper trimmer like this. I'm also going to trim my main pattern paper down using my paper trimmer to the size of my A2 card front. And now I can start assembling all those fun layers. I had a, as I started to put that scrap from this on back over on my pile of card supplies, I started looking at the backside since all these papers are reversible, and I thought it might be kind of fun to add a little strip of that in there. So I kind of tucked it in there while I started assembling everything else, and then I could kind of think about it a little and decide if I really wanted to do that once I got it put together. As it ended up, I did, but I'll do this a lot when I'm layering pattern paper and kind of put it in there and think about it, see how it all looks when it's layered together. And as you can see, I kind of did that and I thought that added a fun touch. So I'm going to go ahead and trim that down to the width of my A2 card, again with my paper trimmers, so 4 1/4. And now I can tuck that in there and just slide everything off to make it easier to put it in. Fun thing with double-sided pattern papers like this, a lot of times the reverse of the same pattern paper coordinates really well. And since they come in 6x6, it makes it super simple and easy to perfectly color coordinate different pattern papers as well, which I love. All right, I'm going to add some foam adhesive on the back of the gnomes. I'm adding the circles just with my tape runner. You could use liquid glue too. I kind of felt like I went back and forth between adhesives, but I just grabbed what I had handy and went with it. So mix and match or use what you're comfortable and familiar with. So I went ahead and added all the circles on, and then I finished adding the gnomes. One little trick with the foam adhesive, I put a larger piece at the bottom, and then if you cut a thin strip and peel off the backing, look how you can kind of curve that foam tape around the hat a little bit at the top. That way you can make sure you have enough to kind of go up there and hit the spot that you want to. You can watch on that one again too, and it's nice how it bends and curves once you take off that paper backing on the back. All right, I'm adding my sentiment with the same foam adhesive. I always keep my scraps kind of stuck on the side of the roll because sometimes I use the extra little pieces like that to fill in a little hole, so I make sure I have enough foam adhesive on there to make it sturdy and solid. All right, final finishing touch here. I wanted to add some little white pom-poms onto the hat. But before I do that, since I'm gonna use liquid glue and that's gonna take a while to dry, I went ahead and adhered that onto my top folding white card base, just using my tape runner again. Then I'm using that same Gina K Connect glue to tuck on there and add those pom-poms onto each spot. And that's gonna be the finishing touch for this little card. I was super happy how cute it came out. It was fun to use those dies in a little bit of a different way. This kit, I am sure, is going to sell out fast. It's one of my favorites in a good long while. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed. I hope this inspired you. Have a wonderful day, and I'll see you again soon. Bye-bye. Thank you.